Hi, it's Katrina. From bicycle paths that glow in the dark to special pavement that helps reduce flooding, here are 10 genius inventions that should be implemented in every city. Number 10, solar charging stations. Communal charging hubs aren't just for airports anymore. The next time you visit New York, be on the lookout for solar stations located around the city that allow users to charge their devices on the street. Called Street Charge, the solar power comes from 3 15-watt solar panels stored in each hub. Units can recharge in just 4 hours of direct sunlight, but they also absorb UV rays during overcast days. The modular design allows the Street Charge units to be moved to better areas if they aren't being utilized enough. There is also potential for the stations to be used for lighting and Wi-Fi connections. Because they are completely self-contained and they do not connect to any external power sources, they would also come in handy in the case of a blackout. You no longer have to fear canceled plans because of a dead smartphone. With these ingenious charging stations, it's easy to top up your device while you're on the go. Number 9. Glow-in-the-dark bicycle paths. Bike paths are becoming the norm in cities around the world, so making them more user-friendly is a high priority. A rural town in Poland introduced a glow-in-the-dark bike path that is the perfect way to prevent accidents when the sun starts to go down. By using a special technology that is embedded in the asphalt, the path charges by day via the sun through synthetic particles called luminophores. Capturing the sunlight during the day, the path glows an electric blue hue that lasts up to 10 hours. After testing out a short section, developers plan to see how the path made it through the winter, and then plan to make longer sections with any improvements they think might be needed. Similarly, a Dutch designer created something called the Starry Night Bike Trail in the town of Eindhoven, where Vincent van Gogh once lived. In 2013, a park in Cambridge, England also covered a path with a spray-on glow-in-the-dark coating as another way to help nighttime cyclists forge their own path. It's a good idea, right? Would you like to see this implemented in your city? How often do you ride your bike? Let me know in the comments! Number 8. Pneumatic waste collection system. In densely populated urban environments, garbage trucks are inefficient and loud, and they obstruct traffic. Garbage itself is unsanitary and invites unwanted pests, both indoors and when it's been put out to the curb. Anyone who's walked in a busy city the night before garbage pickup knows firsthand that it's an eyesore, and it smells. To reduce or eliminate the presence of disruptive garbage trucks on the street and of garbage, many cities throughout the world have implemented something called automated vacuum waste collection systems, or AVAC. Waste collection points are placed throughout a city. They're conveniently located and accessible 24/7. These surface collection points are connected to a series of underground pipes. Garbage that is dropped off accumulates in an underground chamber until it reaches a certain level, at which point it triggers a sensor that begins the emptying process. The waste is sucked into the pipes and transported to a central waste station. Once it arrives, it's automatically sorted and placed into the proper containers, which are then driven by truck to landfills or composting stations. These systems are made with relatively simple technology that has been around for a while. They're beneficial for reducing the air pollution caused by garbage and garbage trucks. AVAC systems can also be cost-saving by reducing the number of waste trucks needed, as well as manpower. AVAC units are becoming increasingly popular in cities. In recent years, these systems have appeared in places like Stockholm, London, Barcelona, and Copenhagen. Does your city have this? Let me know in the comments! And now for one of my personal favorites, but first just wanted to say a quick thank you to these people for their nice comments. I really appreciate the positivity and we are always working hard to be better and better. Couldn't do it without you. Number 7, an urban oasis. A vertical garden tower in Singapore known as Park Royal on Pickering features overflowing gardens and water features that have turned the bustling city into a lush urban oasis. This 12-story high tower, located in the west part of the city's central business district, features massive curvaceous solar-powered sky gardens. By using automatic light, rain, and motion sensors, rainwater harvesting and recycling mechanisms, this modern tower in the historic district is the epitome of eco-friendly. Natural materials such as light and dark wood, pebbles, and water make up the interior space bathed in natural light, while a large pool overlooks the city and a 300-meter-long garden strip. By intertwining natural and technological systems, this innovative design is an inspiration for those building more earth-conscious designs and shows how modern architecture can also be eco-friendly. Hopefully the future is greener, even in cities being taken over by hot cement. Number 6. Clean energy sources. One idea for improving cities that is slowly gaining ground is the implementation of clean energy sources in city centers. To achieve this objective, the energy sources must be efficient enough to truly benefit the city and be non-invasive, so they don't interrupt the already congestion-prone flow of people and traffic. Can you think of a solution? One invention with potential is the e-tree by the Israeli company Sologic. It's equipped with solar panels, offering shade to passersby, and can power numerous USB sockets. It can also power a water pump for a nearby fountain. The 4.5-meter tree provides 1,400 watts of power, working out to 2,500 kilowatt-hours annually. Wind turbine technology is another potential way of introducing clean energy into an urban environment. The Wind Tree by New World Wind has three steel trunks stemming into tiny branches, which hold 36 leaf-shaped turbines. These turbines take advantage of even the slightest breeze, producing around 2,400 kilowatt-hours annually, which is enough to power around 15 streetlights and a number of smartphones. Solar and wind technology are unlikely to ever meet the energy needs for an entire city, but they're being increasingly integrated into urban landscapes as a way to offset the use of power from other sources. Number 5. Hourglass traffic lights. Every city dweller knows the fear of trying to make it across a busy downtown street before the light turns red. A designer in Estonia created an innovative traffic light with LED timers that show you just how long you have to make it across the road safely. The sensible interactive design shows a digital display of the countdown both in color and countdown numbers. Easy to see, the lights, which look like a real sand glass timer, show how long to wait, hurry, or just go. The countdown numbers appear only while the yellow light is on to warn that it will change in a few seconds, making it easy for busy commuters and pedestrians alike to make the most of their busy schedule. Number 4. Battery recycling station that lights sidewalks. Although most modern devices now use rechargeable batteries, there are still those items in everyone's home that use alkaline batteries. All that makes for a lot of waste over the average year, but a new innovation called the Energy Seed allows people to recycle their batteries into something more useful. The LED lamppost is powered by discarded alkaline batteries. With slots for nearly every size of battery, the unit takes any leftover power from the batteries and channels it into a super efficient LED ring. By using the leftover charges and gathering them all in one place, proper disposal of the batteries is easy and prevents them from ending up in local landfills. By using this innovative design, there are less chemicals ending up in the environment, polluting our land, and those last remaining seeds of energy can be used to power the light stands, making the environment safer as well at night. Number 3. Edible water bubbles. Have you ever been caught on the run without something to drink but don't want to contribute to the Earth's pollution by buying a bottle of water? These edible water bubbles may just be the thing you need. Known as uho, these edible pods made from natural seaweed extract are filled with clean drinking water. In case you're worried that these will simply contribute to more waste, the seaweed is biodegradable, and if they are not used for more than 6 weeks, they simply disintegrate. The team behind the idea, Skipping Rocks Lab, is actually a group of young adults from Imperial College in London. They first introduced their idea back in 2013, and since then they've been working to make their idea a success. After a successful crowdfunding campaign, the team raised $750,000, proving that consumers everywhere are looking for innovative and eco-friendly solutions to reduce their plastic waste. Number 2. Portable pollution absorbers. The air pollution that concentrates in city centers tends to linger, even with the help of green walls and the occasional plant or tree. A Berlin-based startup called Green City Solutions expanded on the idea of reducing air pollution through greenery by developing the City Tree, a transportable, ready-to-use green wall. The designers of the 4-meter-high wall, which is lined with mosses known for their high pollutant-absorbing abilities, believe it has the capacity to equate the pollutant absorption capacity of 275 trees. Within a few dozen meter range, a city tree absorbs 15% of the nitrogen oxides in the air and 25% of fine particulate matter. It has a self-watering system powered by solar panels and a computer that sends an ongoing stream of measurement data. The wall would be especially useful for reducing pollution in areas with high traffic and vehicle congestion. Sounds nice, but kind of sad that there are no trees. We will ultimately need to reduce fuel consumption for any serious long-term improvements to urban pollution. But in the meantime, as we work toward that goal, products like this can help to improve our air quality. Number 1. Porous pavement that prevents flooding. In 2004, the Environmental Services Organization in Portland, Oregon, paved three blocks of their Westmoreland neighborhood with permeable pavement that allows water to go through from the street surface to the ground. The interlocking blocks look like brick, but are actually high-strength concrete. By allowing water to infiltrate the ground through the spaces between the blocks, the amount of stormwater that flows through sewer pipes is reduced and discharged directly into local rivers and streams. Because heavy rains and stormwater can discharge into the streams and pollute water, this project can reduce stream pollution and sewer backups. In 2005, the city also paved four blocks of their Northgate Avenue neighborhood with this new design, again as a way to combat sewerage backups and wastewater overflowing. Using this innovative design as a way to see how different pavement materials handle stormwater, the city installed and monitored different pavement combinations to find the best way to bring innovation to the city in a more natural way. Thanks for watching! Which of these inventions would you like to see in your city? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Bye!